Eid al-Ghadir is an event that all Muslims should be celebrating. If truly the Prophet appointed Imam Ali alayhi salam as a successor, then why did the people not follow him? There has never been a case where either a prophet or a successor of a prophet has ever been chosen by people. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Muhammadin wa alihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to the 7th episode of these special series discussing Eid al-Ghadir. Over the past few episodes, we looked at the concept or the theory of council or shura or voting system with regards to choosing imams in Islam. And we saw that there was absolutely no precedence for such a theory before the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, or even after the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Then we said that if that is the case, then the Prophet must have appointed somebody, and that somebody was Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi as his successor, as his khalifa. And there were several confirmations to this from the Holy Quran, from the Sunnah and the traditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, that finally led to the day of Eid al-Ghadir, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi took the hands of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi and said that whomever I'm his master, Ali is his master, as we discussed in the previous episodes, where there were tens of thousands of Muslims witnessing the event, and they pledged their allegiance to Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam as their khalifa. But then what happened after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, there was a setback. Many companions, unfortunately, deliberately disobeyed and betrayed their allegiance to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi and to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. And hence they disobeyed the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The majority, in fact, disobeyed, and only few, handful of individuals who remained loyal to Imam Ali alayhi salam and remained faithful to him. So the question that is likely to be posed is, how is it possible that you have so many Muslims, you were saying tens of thousands of people pledge their allegiance to Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, how is it that they all changed, or the majority of them changed? Is that possible? These companions who fought with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, defended Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, how is it possible? To answer this question, we need to go back to the Quran, and let's take a look at some examples from the Quran from before the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, where people betrayed their allegiance. The first example we'll take a look at is the example of Prophet Musa and Prophet Harun alayhi salam. When Prophet Musa alayhi salam just saved Bani Israel, just saved them from the water and from Fir'aun, they came across a group of people who were worshipping idols. This is in the Quran. They told their prophet Musa alayhi salam, they said, why don't you make us idol like those people so we can worship them as well? Now they've just witnessed the greatest miracle. Allah has just saved them, and they're asking their prophet to make them idols so that they can worship them. Now, a Samari who was a companion of Musa alayhi salam saw that, and he kept it all in mind. Then when the time came, of course, Musa alayhi salam told them, how could you even ask me for something like this when Allah has just saved us? Allah is the one who protects us. He looks after us. So while Musa alayhi salam was there, everything was okay, but you could see there was something cooking up here. Those people asking Musa alayhi salam to create a god for them, wal-iyadu billah, that they could worship, despite all these miracles they have witnessed from Musa alayhi salam, they're asking for this. But as long as Musa alayhi salam was with them, they were okay. They couldn't really show their hatred. But when the time came for Musa alayhi salam to leave, to go and get the Torah, and he chose 70 people, he chose them to go with him, whom he thought were pious believers. So he took them with him. And then he put Harun alayhi salam as their leader. Musa told them, I will go for 30 days because that's what Allah has told me. But then Allah added 10 more days. And these 10 days were added to test Bani Israel, the children of Israel. Now you brothers and sisters, tell me what happened. As-Samiri came, when the 30 days passed and Musa did not come back, As-Samiri came and said, you know what? Musa is gone, he probably has died. Let me create for you a god that you can worship. Bring me your jewelry. They brought their jewelry, and Musa and As-Samiri created for them a calf that they started worshiping as their god. Now you tell me, this is less than 40 days after the departure of Musa alayhi salam. It is said that about 600,000 of Bani Israel worshipped the calf, when in fact only 12,000 remained loyal to Harun alayhi salam. That's about 2%. 2%. What happened to the remaining 98%? What happened? You tell me. What happened when Harun came to them and told them, people, what you're doing is wrong. How can you forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is mentioned in Surah Taha? They told him, forget about you. And in fact, they wanted to kill Harun. When Musa alayhi salam came back and asked his brother, he said, why didn't you stop them? He said, I tried. I spoke to them. I told them what you're doing is wrong. But they realized my weakness. All these 600,000 of them, there's only 12,000 of us. And he tells him, they were about to kill me. So don't blame me, brother, for what they have done. And Musa said, I'm not blaming you. He comes angry. Isn't that a precedence? That's one. Now someone will say, this is before the time of the Prophet. This is not the time of the Sahaba, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Brothers and sisters, the Quran, is it revealed for the time before Rasulullah or for the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or is it revealed for all times? Why does Allah tell us about the story of Harun and Musa alayhim as-salam and them and Bani Israel worshipping the calf? It is to give us a lesson that throughout history you will have people like As-Samiri, people who will come in the form of religious people, companions of messengers, but they will deviate people. And that's what As-Samiri did. So that is a lesson for us. It means it is possible. Now, let's go to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that was an example from before Rasulullah in the Quran, mentioned in Surah Taha and Surah Al-A'raf and some other surahs that talk about this story. Then we come to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now brothers and sisters, what happened in the Battle of Uhud? The Battle of Uhud. Go read the books of history, see what historians say. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi puts 50 arrowmen or archers on a mountain, and he tells them that I don't want you to move until I signal to you to come. These people deliberately disobeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When they saw the Muslims winning initially, they descended from the mountain. Their leader, a man by the name of Abdullah, told them, don't go down. The Prophet has not given us permission to go down. They said, forget about him. If we don't go down, we will miss out on the booty, the war booty. So they go down. Abdullah and two or three other people remain on the mountain. When Khalid ibn al-Walid, who was the leader of the mushrikeen at the time, realized this, he turned around, killed the archers. And what happened? He sandwiched the Muslims in the middle. And so many Muslims got killed, great companions like Mus'ab ibn Umayr radwanullahi ta'ala alayh, the father of Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, Abdullah al-Ansari radwanullahi ta'ala alayh, the greatest martyr, Sayyid al-Shuhada of his time, Hamza radwanullahi ta'ala alayh, was killed as well. So, and what happened? The Muslims, they all ran away. And the Prophet is calling them, come back. Read Surah Ali Imran, where 60 verses were revealed about this issue. 60 verses. And the Prophet is calling them, إِذْ تُصْعِدُونَ وَلَا تُلْوُونَ. Means you go up the mountain and you don't even look back. And the Prophet is calling you, come back. And you ignore him. What happened there? Only a handful of Muslims remained with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And historians all agree unanimously that Ali ibn Abi Talib remained, Abu Dujana remained, and a lady by the name of Nasibah bint Ka'ab al-Maziniyah, she remained, a woman, started defending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And whereas the most of the men, they ran away. And the Quran, when Allah describes what those people did, He blames them. He says, in verse 144 of Surah Ali Imran, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرَّسُولِ. Muhammad is not but a messenger. Other messengers have come before him. أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلْ. Is it when he dies or he gets killed? انقلبتم على أعقابكم. You return to your old state. What is the old state? Of kufr. This is not return or running away from the battlefield. No, it's not a matter of just running away. People deliberately disobeyed the Prophet here, because people ran away also in other battles like Hunayn. But Allah did not use this word, انقلبتم على أعقابكم. You go back to your original state, to your state of kufr, of shirk والعياذ بالله. Which means those Muslims who disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam made a major sin that could have caused the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciated from those few individuals who remained loyal to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi by fighting with him, defending him, a handful of individuals. And I can guarantee you, and I challenge people to go back and to prove that most of the Sahaba remained. In fact, most of them ran away. And if you want, you can refer to a book called As-Sahih min Sirat al-Nabi al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa alihi by Sayyid Ja'far Murtada al-Amili, where he describes and discusses this whole event, proving that indeed the majority ran away, with the exception of Ali ibn Abi Talib salamullahi alayhi, where there is unanimous agreement among historians, he remained. Most of the others, we don't really know. Nonetheless, that is a clear example. Then when the people realized that the Prophet is still alive, they came back and Allah forgave the Muslims. So that battle of Uhud is a clear example. These are companions who were with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, yet they deliberately disobeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. They disobeyed the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would have caused Islam and the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. In fact, they caused the death of Hamza salamullahi alayhi. That is example from the time of Rasulullah. That's one. Two, the second example from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is the battle of Hunayn. Hunayn. What happened in Hunayn? After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi got control or took control over Mecca, there was a tribe or a group by the name of Hawazin. Hawazin, they teamed up with other Arabs who prepared a big army to come and fight against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When the Prophet learned about them, he prepared an army of 12,000 men. Many of them were those who were freed by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi in Mecca. So the newcomers to Islam, which are known at that stage as At-Tulaqa, the ones who were freed. Among those people were Abu Sufyan, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. All of those people are from the Tulaqa. Tulaqa is the expression given by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi to those people who told them, I set you all free, go. فَاذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَقَاءُ. Free. So they became known as the Tulaqa, those people in Mecca, when the Prophet could control over them and he released them. So the army contained some of those people. And some of the Muhajireen, some of the Ansar, great companions, 12,000 of them, they come, they march towards Hawazin. And what happens? Allah tells us in the Quran, read Surah At-Tawbah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنٍ إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا وَضَاقَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأَرْضُ بِمَا رَحُبَتْ ثُمَّ وَلَّيْتُمْ مُدْبِرِينَ. And on the day of Hunayn, when you thought that, look at us, we have 12,000 people, the arrogance entered into the heart of the Muslims. That, you know what, we conquered Mecca, we conquered other cities, we fought in other battles, and we become victorious. Now that we have 12,000 people, we can definitely win against these Hawazin. Allah wanted to discipline the Muslims, teach them a lesson. However, what happened? Hawazin started shooting arrows and attacking the Muslims. And what happened? Allah says, ثُمَّ وَلَّيْتُمْ مُدْبِرِينَ. You ran away. ثُمَّ وَلَّيْتُمْ مُدْبِرِينَ. Ran away. Read Sirat Ibn Husham. Read what others say. Muslims ran away. In fact, in Sahih al-Bukhari, a man by the name of Abu Qutada, he says, I ran away, and then I saw the man who became the second Khalifa. I said to him, what are you doing? He says, this is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wanted us to run away. He's blaming, wal'iyadu billah, Allah, for making him run away from the battlefield. Wal'iyadu billah. Do you accept this logic? And the Prophet is calling them, come back. Again, they deliberately disobeyed the Prophet, left him by himself. Bani Hashim stayed, defending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and Ali ibn Abi Talib defended Rasulullah. He in fact went among the mushrikeen, started fighting them, taking them as prisoners, tying them up and bringing them to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Then he attacked the bearers of the banners and he started killing them. And he turned the whole equilibrium of the battle. Sirat Husham, Ibn Husham in his Sirah, he says, Muslims started returning back when they saw the prisoners tied up next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. Who tied them up? Who got them? When they all ran away, it was Ali ibn Abi Talib, salamullahi alayhi. So Muslims ran away, except for a few individuals. Bani Hashim remained because some people from the Tulaqa, some people, a man by the name of Uthman ibn Abi Talha, ibn Shayba ibn Abi Talha, that man, he tried to kill Rasulullah. He was from the Tulaqa, those who are freed by. So he was fighting next to Rasulullah, but he wanted to kill him, and the Prophet told him. So he said, I bear witness you are Rasulullah, you are a messenger of Allah, because you knew what I was thinking about. So there was betrayal. And people deserted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This is in the battle of Hunayn. Then what happens? A third example, battle of Tabuk. In the battle of Tabuk, you had some hypocrites who remained behind and did not join Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. In fact, they built Masjid Dhirar, a mosque, which the Quran describes as dharar, a mosque of harm, that when the Prophet came back from Tabuk, Allah ordered him to destroy it, in fact, to burn it. Can you believe it? Somebody says the Prophet burned the masjid. Yes, he did. Masjid dharar. Because this masjid was just named as a masjid, but rather it was an operation cell to spy on the Muslims. So the Prophet wanted to destroy it. So he destroyed it. And then there were people who neglected the command of Rasulullah, thalatha, three people. Quran mentions them in Surah At-Tawbah, who left. Rasulullah did not join him. So basically you have a whole range of companions who more than one occasion deliberately disobeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Uhud, in Hunayn, in Tabuk. Then why do we get surprised that after the Prophet's death, the majority of the companions also changed? When in fact, in Sahih al-Bukhari, it is narrated from Abi Hurairah, the Prophet himself says, I will stand on the Day of Judgment next to the river, and some of my companions will come and will be dragged to Jahannam. I will say, O Allah, these are my companions. They would say, you don't know what they did after you. You don't know what they did after you. So some writers are trying to kind of patch things up and say, well, these companions are not the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Well, he's saying, my companions, ashabi, or usayhabi, a group of them who will be, don't tell me that they were hypocrites, whatever. Yes, some of the hypocrites are there as well. But some of those who are companions of Rasulullah disobeyed and changed. You had companions fighting each other after Rasulullah on the battle of Jamal. Amir al-Mu'mini Ali ibn Abi Talib with Ammar ibn Yasir with Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr radwanullah ta'ala alayh. They were fighting against Talha and Zubair and Umm al-Mu'mineen who joined them as well. So they were companions, and Talha got killed in that battle. Talha got killed in the battle. So don't tell me that companions did not go. And this was during the Khilafah of Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib. People changed. So unfortunately what happened is we see there is precedence in the Quran from the time of Musa alayhi salam to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and after Rasulullah, where people deliberately disobeyed the command of their Prophet, and Sahaba, companions, disobeyed the Prophet, and even after his death they also sat back and disobeyed the Prophet, which resulted in the Khilafah of the first Khalifa and them pushing away Imam Ali. Now a question you might pose, so what? Okay, you tell me that Ali did not become a Khalifa, the first Khalifa became. Isn't everything fine afterwards? We will discuss that in the next episode and the final episode of this special series about Eid al-Ghadir. Until I see you then, inshallah, may Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahumma
salli ala Ahlul Bayt TV, the holy household for every household.